Our morning service, and we're going to sing an old chorus. Some of you may not know this chorus. I think the last time I have a recording recorded that it was sung at this church was in 2004, and that's 12 years ago. And for those of you that remember Randy Morrison, it's a song that Randy Morrison had led, but this morning it was on my heart, so we're going to sing it. If you don't know it, listen to it once or twice, you'll know it. It's simple. God is great. Geneva Ossel, one of her daughters passed away, Now she has more than one daughter, and I don't remember her daughter's name. Does anybody know both of her daughter's names? No. One of her daughters passed away, and she is going to be at Kudus Funeral Home Tuesday. So if you would happen to know her, you'd be welcome to go. I don't have more information than that, unfortunately. But all the way back when Sister Butler was teaching the ladies' Bible class, apparently she came and was part of that. So she has some connection to Friendship Assembly, but it was way before I was the pastor. I don't personally know her. But if you would be interested in going, you can call Midge or call Sister Geneva, and they can get you that information. So pray for them. I was talking to Midge about it, and she told me she was just hoping she had gave her life to the Lord in time. And I know that's especially difficult for a parent when they don't know if their child is in heaven or not. That's a very, very dark and difficult place to be at. So keep her mom in prayer, and I'm sure she would greatly appreciate it. She would covet your prayers today. Precious Heavenly Father, we're so thankful to be here in your house. We know it's your house because you're here. For where two or three are gathered together, you're there in the midst of them. And our desire today, O Lord, is to lift you up. Our desire today is to reach our hands out to you and grab hold of the hem of your garment and to realize, O Lord, that you are moving even now. I pray, Lord, that you would have your perfect way in Jesus' wonderful name. And everyone said, amen. You deserve the glory and the
Thank you, God, for never changing.
Hallelujah. Speaks like that, it's because there's people that have been struggling with that very thing. But we always have to turn our face back to the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Miracles come in different ways. Some people need a miracle where God would move on their spouse's life so they get saved. Some people need a miracle so that their children get saved. Some people need a miracle for healing in their body. Sometimes the Lord needs to work a miracle just to get us up and doing something for Him. But this is what I know. God is able. And even though there may be all kinds of things that swirl around us, we have to keep turning our face back to Jesus. Back to Jesus. He is the author and finisher of our faith. Amen?
Praise God.
He is the high tower.
Yes, He is.
He is the rock that we are building our lives upon. Amen. And back to Christ we go time and time again, and we find out He's all I need. Amen. Jesus is all I need. Hallelujah. Brother Leonard's going to come at this time and lead us in some hymns. While he's coming, we'll go and have our brethren come to receive our Sunday morning tithes and offerings. I also would like to make mention, if you were not able to be at the business meeting that we had last week, and you would like a copy of the financial report, just see one of us after service. We'll make sure that we get a copy of that for you. Brother Sip, would you pray over the offering?
I must tell Jesus, number 400. you washed in the blood. Number 436, I believe, or 236. Are you washed in the blood?
You know, I don't know what people do, without the Lord. I really don't. Regardless how bad things get, you know, it can always get bad. Things can always change as long as you know the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That's a miracle.
Praise the Lord. That's right.